unsealed and finally revealed.
Without redaction, in full, the palace letters.
All 220 of them, 1,200 pages, never intended for the prying eyes of the Australian public.
We've achieved, I think, legally a little bit of colonial upstartery.
November 11, 1975. I have taken a decisive step and terminated the commission of the former Prime Minister, Mr. Whitlam. I decided to take the step I took without informing the palace in advance, because under the Constitution, the responsibility is mine.
Well, may we say, God save the Queen. Because nothing will save the Governor-General.
It was best, Sir John Kerr told the Queen's private secretary, Her Majesty did not know in advance. There have been some who have questioned what you have done, but I have as yet found no one who has been able to tell me what you ought to have done instead to resolve the crisis. I believe that in not informing the Queen what you intended to do before doing it, you acted not only with constitutional propriety, but also with admirable consideration for Her Majesty's position.
I mean, it was not her place to involve herself one way or the other.
She might not have, but the palace certainly did, discussing the Governor-General's controversial reserve powers for months. Told by Gough Whitlam the crisis could end in a race to the palace to see who could get there first, Sir John Kerr was informed the matter was of extreme interest to the Queen. I think you are playing the vice-regal hand with skill and wisdom. The fact that you have powers is recognised, but it is also clear that you will only use them in the last resort, and then only for constitutional and not for political reasons.
These are not appropriate conversations to be had between a Governor-General and a member of the royal family.
Kerr was making it very clear to the palace that he was thinking about dismissing the Prime Minister. The palace should have said, in my view, the palace should have said, don't do it.
I think it is good that people should know that the Queen is being informed, but of course, this does not mean that she has any wish to intervene, even if she had the constitutional power to do so. The crisis, as you say, has to be worked out in Australia.
It is, I think, a blight on our character as a nation that a democratically elected government was dismissed.
The documents, which were intended to be secret for at least 60 years, also reveal Gough Whitlam responded to his dismissal with a very great rage. Anger he encouraged true believers to maintain for decades, helping to inspire a new generation of Republicans.
Well, absolutely. We need an Australian head of state who represents Australians first and only, and is accountable to Australians.
Raising questions about the secrecy surrounding documents penned by other governors general.
You know, honestly, I don't know. I'm very interested to find out, and I'm very minded to find out.
He's not alone. The archive's website crashing, unable to cope with the number of people logging in to learn about this iconic and no longer secret chapter in Australia's history. Brett Mason, SBS World News.